Hi everyone, in this video, I want to talk about how we can begin defining functions in Python. So, what does a function in Python even mean? Think of a function in Python like a box that performs some action every time it is called. So, every time our Python interpreter sees our function, it'll go to that function and perform that code, and then it will return and continue on with our code. I think this is best taught through an example, so let's do that. Let's create a command that will accept in a time in seconds and convert that into hours, minutes, and seconds. So, we start with the function by defining it. So, we type def for define, and then we give our function a name. So, let's call it timeConvert. Then inside these parentheses, we need to define what are called parameters. These are values that we require from our user to use our function. So, if we had more parameters, let's say 3, then our user would need to give us 3 pieces of information, called the arguments, to satisfy all of our parameters. So the parameter are the values that we take in from our user, and the arguments are the values that our users give us to satisfy our parameters. So, in our function here, we only need a single parameter. That is, the amount of time in seconds that we are going to convert to hours, minutes, and seconds. And then using the following bit of code, we can find the amount of hours, minutes, and seconds for the given argument value. This bit of code here is explained in our modulo operator video, for which I will post a link in the description below if you're interested. Now, we have officially made our first function in Python, so let's test it out to make sure that it is working properly. So, to call our function, we simply type the name of the function and give our argument for the parameter inside the parentheses. As you can see here, at least in the PyCharm IDE, our timeConvert function autofills and it shows us how many arguments we need to give it, and the parameter name that it will take in as the argument. In the next video, we are going to go through how to accept multiple arguments and the difference between keyword and positional arguments. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we can make functions in Python and how to use them. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.